umpire supporters hitting a bump in the road today. Cincinnati has now been denied federal funds for the project. Now, we broke the story on our website, WLWT.com. Tonight, News Source John London joining us live with new details in our number four story. John?
Well, Cherie, Tucson, New Orleans, Dallas, and Portland got a combined $154 million. Cincinnati scored a goose egg. Now, that sounds bad, but the mayor and managers see no reason to lament. Here's why.
They know without federal funding, Cincinnati's streetcar plan goes nowhere. City leaders insist they're not down in the mouth about today's announcement.
And the fact that we did not get money in the first round of the Tiger Grant is not the death of the streetcar.
$60 million signs dangled in their heads all winter. Privately, there was considerable talk that the city was right on track for it.
And despite all the mayor's trips to Washington, D.C., and all the supposed pull that he had with the Obama administration, Cincinnati's left out in the cold.
But the mayor maintains the city is still in the game. He and the manager have been invited to a streetcar summit with federal leaders next week, an opportunity to once again spotlight the project where it must count, the federal purse.
You know, these things are large projects. You have to have the long view.
Which is pursue other grants, continue the planning, and stay on track with the broad agenda of the banks, casino, and streetcar.
Yes, it would have been nice to get money from this particular source, but even if we were so inclined, we don't have time to hang our heads and say, woe is me.
Now, those other grants they talk about add up to $75 million. They'll hear about one this spring, the other in the summer, but no matter how you cut it, the city's 0-for-2 at the streetcar plate. Corporate backing did not come through, and so far, neither has federal support. Jack?